Good morning, students. In last class, we were discussing about the organization of data. So under that, we discussed meaning of raw data. Okay, and also we understood, like we discussed about examples through tables. Okay, so raw data, it is an unorganized data. We cannot understand properly and we cannot solve the problems. So to understand the economic problems, we have to collect the economic and social issues, like social activities or problems. What for? To provide solution, to solve the economic problems. So when we are collecting the information, so that is not a complete data, that is not an organized data, that is, we can say, like raw data. So raw data cannot give a clear picture about the problems. That's why we have to classify the data. We have to classify the data depends upon the requirement. Depend upon the requirement. That is based on purpose. Actually, always we are arranging our books like subject wise. You know that very well. According to subjects like economics, like business, like computer science, like accountancy, like Kannada, like English. Like that also we are arranging. But instead of arranging like this, we could make it arrangement in the name of authors, like alphabetically. So we can arrange the books according to subjects, but instead of that, we can arrange the books. Otherwise, you could have classified the books in the name of authors, like alphabetically. The name of authors, like alphabetically. Whose name is starting letter of B, like C, like D. That is, this way also we can make arrangement of books. And also, like in the published years, and also we can divide that. We can also classify the books like in the publishing year. In the publishing year, instead of arrangement of books according to subject name, we are also can make arrangement the books using which one, like using the author names, or in the alphabetical, and on the alphabetical order, in the alphabetical order, and also their published years. As even raw data cannot give a clear picture. That's why we have to organize the raw data. How? That is depends upon the classification. Actually, the data can be classified into four ways. So what are the ways? That is depends upon the requirement. So now in this class, we have to discuss about the classification of data. So there are four classification. First one is chronological classification, second one spatial classification, third one qualitative classification, fourth one quantitative classification. Okay, the data can be classified into four ways. The classification of data can be divided into four ways. One is chronological classification. Second one is spatial classification. Third one is qualitative classification. And fourth one is quantitative classification. Actually, what we are collecting data, that is not in an organized data. So that is considered as a raw data. Then we have to make it properly. Then we have to make arrangement. So which is belongs to which one? So which is like numbers, like numerical, which is like theory, which is like information. So which is fact. Okay, that is only we have to understand. So that's why the data can be classified into four ways. One is chronological classification, spatial classification, qualitative classification, quantitative classification. Okay, one by one we have to discuss. First, we have to discuss about the chronological classification. So, chronological classification, what is the meaning of this? The data can be grouped. The data can be grouped into on the basis of time. The data can be grouped according to time. The data can be grouped according to the time. According to time, that is called only chronological data. Chronological data, that is data can be mentioned in the like years, in the numbers, in the percentage. Okay, that is in the quarters, months, days. That is only, that is in the base of time. Time means like that is year, that is quarter, that is month, that is week, that is day. Okay, on the base of time, what we are classifying the data, that is called as chronological data. Chronological data means, see, the data can be grouped according to time. The data can be grouped according to time. Time means that is year, that is quarterly, like 6 months, and also monthly, then weekly, then day wise. Like this, when we are classified the data on the basis of time, that is called as chronological classification. This can be explained with the help of table. See students, we are discussing about chronological classification. Chronological classification is nothing but the data can be grouped according to time. Actually, the classification of data, the first important thing is chronological. The data can be classified into four ways. First one is chronological data, like chronological classification. Second one is spatial classification. Third one is qualitative classification. Fourth one is quantitative classification. So first, we are discussing about the chronological classification. Chronological classification is nothing but data can be classifying into. That is, the data can be classifying on the base of time. The data can be grouped according to time, or time basis. Actually, so for that, there is an example, that is population of India, that is in crores. So when we are calculating the, which one? Population. So that is based on which one? Yearly. So actually the chronological classification, that is a time basis, either ascending, either descending, like increasing or decreasing. Okay, so here especially in this chronological classification, we can mention like year, like quarterly, 6 months, like 1 month, even day, like week or day. That is time basis. Chronological completely belongs to or are completely based on time basis. So that for that sake, we have to observe an example. What is the population of India? That is in crores. So it is also called as a time series. Either ascending, either descending order. We can mention the data. So here, this is the data. That is the main intention is when it was, that is in the, like yearly, at the time of 1951, 35.7 crores. Just imagination. According to year of 1951, the population was in our country, that is 35.7 crores. At the time of 1961, that is 43.8 crores. At the time of 1971, 54.6 crores. So that is only imagination.
So this data can be calculated in terms of which one? Year. So this is timings. This is called as chronological classification. The chronological classification, the data can be grouped. The data can be grouped according to time. According to time, that is time is very important. When the population is crossed, okay, when, at which time, that is very important. That time can be classified in the way of chronological. Either that time is ascending or descending, like increasing or decreasing. So that's why it is called as time series. Okay, this is called as chronological classification. So especially population, always we can calculate in terms of years only. Every 10 years once the census will conduct the counting of population. You know that very well, right? So as like guys, we are discussing about which one? Chronological classification. Chronological classification means the data can be grouped according to time. The data can be grouped according to time. That is called as chronological classification. This chronological classification we can calculate like in through years or quarterly, like 6 months, like months, like weekly, okay, or day wise. We can calculate this. The data can be grouped according to time. So that is called as chronological classification. This is the very important. So the year is chronological classification. Okay, it is also called as time series data. Time series data. Okay, this is chronological classification. Okay, next, special classification. Second one is okay. Special classification. This is also pronounced as special classification. Special classification. It is also raw data. So especially this can study in the geographical locations. Geographical locations. See, the special class that is classified with geographical locations. Geographical locations. Geographical locations like such as countries. That is, we can say like that. Countries, as like as states. And districts. Even like taluks. Okay, etc. The data are classified with the reference to the geographical locations. Geographical locations like country wise, state wise, district wise, even taluk wise, like city wise also. Okay, cities, countries, states, districts, taluks, cities. Okay, the spatial classification can be divided on the basis of geographical locations. Geographically, that is country wise, state wise, districts wise, taluk wise, city wise. This is called as spatial. In previous, chronological, that is based on time. So this is based on geographical locations. So to understand this, you have to see a table. Yeah, see students, we are discussing about spatial classification. Spatial classification. So this is depends upon the, or this can be classified on the basis of geographical locations. Geographical locations like countries, states, districts, taluks, like cities. Okay, on the basis of places, geographical locations only, we can divide the data, we can classify the data. So for that, there is an example, that is yield of wheat for different countries. Yield of wheat for different countries. Okay, I just now only explained
This classification can be done on the basis of geographical locations, places. That is depends upon the places. See here, there is a table. This is also this table. There are many states, like many countries. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 countries are there. So these are all on the base of alphabet. Okay, in the order of alphabet, you can observe America, Brazil, China, Denmark, France, India. And also, you have to understand here yield of wheat for different countries. Yield of wheat, right? ಯಾವ ಯಾವ ಕಂಟ್ರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಎಷ್ಟೆಷ್ಟು ವೀಟ್ ಅನ್ನು ಬೆಳೀತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೀಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಟೇಬಲ್ ವಿ ಶುಡ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದ ಇಯರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟೈಮಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಇಯರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ದ ಪ್ಲೇಸಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಬೇಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ವೈಸ್ district, like state wise, district wise, city wise also we can mention. Okay, so here country America, how many kgs per acre? That is 1925 kgs. Brazil 127 kgs. China 893 kgs. Denmark 225 kgs. France 439 kgs. India 862 kgs. That is kgs per acre, per acre. Okay, you have to observe here the countries. It is in an alphabetical way. See, America, Brazil, China, Denmark, France, India. So this is depends upon the, that is based on the places. Basis on the places. Okay, don't forget chronological, basis on time. Spatial classification, basis on place. Geographical locations or geographical boundary. That is countries, states, districts, even cities like taluk. That is also we can consider as a spatial classification. The data can be classified on the basis of requirement. How you can classify it? There are four. One is chronological, second one is spatial, third one is qualitative, and fourth one is quantitative. Okay. Remaining two we will discuss in next class. Thank you.